You're gonna walk out now. I've built you this lovely office.
Take care of the vault.
Fine, fine. We're gonna do great. I'm gonna turn this into a shining beacon of hope. We need a new overseer. Do you think Clem is up to the job of overseer? And we're back, and I am now officially the overseer of Vault 88, I think. I don't seem to be able to assign anybody to the overseer's desk, so I'm assuming that means I am it. I can sit at the overseer's desk. Oh, good grief. Prime Directive. Confidential. Overseer eyes only. Vault 88 is designed to test a variety of prototype devices with the aim of rolling them out to the rest of the vaults. Once 88 is fully operational, we expect to roll out new devices every fiscal quarter. The initial prototypes are admittedly rough, so do the best you can with them. Unlike other vaults, we'll send test subjects before any disaster scenario. Best estimate is early 2078, you'll have your first batch. Use each batch as long as feasible, but we are prepared to replace personnel if there are complications. Quick iteration time is a must. If the vault goes on lockdown, the urgency of the timetable diminishes, so you'll have to keep the test subjects docile and in line. We have every faith you're up to the task, Dr. Barstow. You know, the more I'm reading this, the happier I am that she's left. Power cycle 1000 analysis. Power levels suboptimal. Power production also spiky. At one point, test subjects got up to answer the call of nature, resulting in a 5-minute 20-second gap of no power. Unacceptable. Evaluation. Failure. Soda fountain analysis. The chemical added to added is a flavor enhancer. There are no additional benefits at all. Evaluation. Dismal failure. Phoropter analysis. This device showed so much potential. Instead, it performed its overt function, admittedly better than a standard phoropter. Evaluation. Failure. Slot machine analysis. The control was never meant to be tested by itself. Of course, the test subject was exuberant. Who wouldn't be on a machine that's programmed to reward the subject an overwhelming percentage of the time? The longer this version of the slot machine is active, the more net resources the vault loses. Evaluation. Total failure. Do not build. Can I change it? Can I change the parameters? I mean, make a bit more money? I'm a little less happy now that... Isn't it weird? Now that I'm the overseer, I'm not sure I have a problem with scanning their habits and keeping track of them. That's terrible, isn't it? I didn't want her keeping track of the residents, but me, you know, I mean, because of course I'm benign, aren't I? Yeah. The allure of power, you see. Now, here's the thing. Security terminal. What exactly are... This just does security logs. Well, that's it then. I'm the overseer. There is one last thing to build before we get to actually making the... Well, the vault... Vaultish. And that is... It's something under miscellaneous. Called the... There you go! The Vault-Tec Population Management System! And... Oh, power. I don't suppose the... Please tell me the, Vault-Tec... Where was it? Here we go. Power conduits can be... Really, I can't build that here. I can't build that here. Really? Really, really? Totally, seriously, really? Well, what actually, out of curiosity... She's winning again. Out of curiosity... If I build lights in here, are they powered? I don't think they are. They're not powered. So I don't have power in here? How is her desk powered? Does it not need power? How it... Okay. So, from the looks of things...
Oh, there's bound to be good ransacking to be had here, eh, sir?
From the looks of things, this seems to be an area I can't really do much with vis-a-vis power. I mean, I can, of course, wire it up. I could wire it up. I'll wire it up. Here's the thing. If I can't power it up and have things here, that's going to make this area a little redundant. I sort of want a... I want a security checkpoint here. Of course, I want it to be powered. And... You know what? The Vault Overseer should not be here. The Vault Overseer should be... in the main vault area. You know what I keep thinking? I'm thinking that this area should be a sort of a communal arrival area with shopping and trading, and that the Vault Seer's office should overlook this. Should this be another one higher, do you think? I kind of feel like it should be another one higher. That, I think, is what I'm going to do next. I'm going to move the Vault Seer's office in that direction. Should I have yet another checkpoint before we let people into the vault proper? This is going to be the vault proper, or should we just assume that can I build?
Yes, I win again.
Oh no, we already have a sliding door here, so and I can build out here. I can actually build things, so yeah, we're going to have the security checkpoint here, then people get led down to the main vault, and this is the first thing they see, a thriving hub of activity. Yes, that's what's going to be here. Then we'll have some kind of doorway heading off to the residential area. I'm going to make this a lot bigger, I think. Yes, I am. And I'm going to make it two stories. My basic thinking is we've got these pieces. I know what you call them. Let me show you. Under the atrium, we have... I don't even know what that is. Prefab end. Prefab end for what? What exactly are these? What are they... Oh, I suppose this... Oh, right. We could have an area that's taller. Oh, I like that.
It's the best.
Okay, no. Anyway, let me show you... There were some prefab things. Probably best to show you outside. Like... this, that you... So I could have a walkway around the outside. Or... Okay, these are the pieces I was looking for. The hanging floors. So I can have... these pieces... Oh, that's a corner, hanging floor, corner, ceiling and floor. Yeah, no, these, right, so that I can have a kind of... Let's oh, you can have one of the doors. So,
you gotta try this,
an area like machine. This, and
the
then stairs going up and more doors into other rooms. That's what I was kind of thinking of. That was my basic... thought process. I'm going to extend this a little, I think. I'm actually just going to rip this apart. I'm going to rip it apart and come up with a floor plan. These guys are not going to like this, but I'm moving their beds back outside. We'll sort a living quarter for you again. I promise, guys. Trust me, you're going to love this. Think of it as a camping escapade. I'll be building you a wonderful vault whilst you all have some fun camping. That'll be nice. Okay, so I can have bridge-like structures as well. That is going to come in very useful, I think. Right, I've got all of the beds moved out of the way. I don't...
You know, touch you? I mean, scratch your body?
Okay, what are they talking about? Oh, I do need to move this. Can you guys move away from Clem unassigned? Probably for the best. Clem, just go over there, please. I want to take the cooking stove out of here. along with, you guys have fun here. Did wiring that up to the power thing actually help power this? No, it didn't. She's not so pedaling hard enough. Oh no, she's pedaling hard enough now to actually turn the terminal on. Can I change the parameters? There's the big question. Nope.
Numbers go.
Okay, right, so, just keep yourself occupied out here while I rip everything apart. I'm not sure about these. They do look kind of useful for holding up the ceiling, don't they? They do. And I'm not totally sure we need that many bridges, but this is what I'm looking at. I am thinking of raising the roof one more, so that even though we're going to have two floors here, we still get a feeling of space, I think is what I'm going for. Before I do that, what I'm going to do is start with the floor plan. I can sort out the columns in a little while. What I want is, I don't know, you come in, maybe the doorways to the shops could be moved in one. I kind of want it to be longer than it is wide. So, right, let's store all the ceiling pieces. This is my basic idea. Not totally sure I like the window so close here, but it's supposed to be a shop. Essentially, you're going to walk through this door. I'm wondering whether it should be one more across. I kind of feel like it should be. I'm tired from lack of sleep. How long have I been at this? Yeah, the basic idea is I'm going to have a little shop. Maybe it's a tiny bit crowded. I kind of feel like I now need to move the entire thing over. I like these corner pieces like this, which means I need to have them relatively well spaced compared to each other, which means this hallway is going to be immense. My thinking here was this would be the bottom floor and I'd have a shop, probably a trader here, maybe a clothes shop on the other side. I'm not in love with placement. I think I'm going to move everything across one. My god, this is going to take forever. Yes, it is. So, inner corner top. Oh, that's that type of thing. Yeah, that would work as well. How about these? Would these inner corner things work? So, what's this? This is the hanging floor. I was going to have these kind of things hanging from the next one up, and they would act as, I think you need to have something. Let's just put this one on for now. That's not going to be there. But then have, oh, it doesn't like that. Hanging floor corner. Why does it not like that? I think I've got a little bit of experimentation to do to find out what I can and cannot achieve here. So that's my basic thinking, except I think I'm going to have the ceiling one higher. So we're going to have two ranks of shops. The other alternative was instead of having this hanging floor, I could have the next shop one step back. So, people actually walk on top of the front of this shop. This shop has a small storage area at the back. This is what I was thinking, to make it look like a reasonable shop. But I do think everything needs to be moved one across. And so, for example, basically like this. I think it's actually a little too big. My original thinking was to just have a normal wall here. It's not actually all that easy to get it to snap into place. It doesn't want to always snap into place. So I was thinking I could have this kind of a wall here, but it doesn't match these. You know, like the metal thing, the metal theme we've got in this area. So in actual fact, it really doesn't actually work that well, which is slightly annoying. Honestly, I think that it was actually better before. So I'm going to move it back. I've got a new settler by the looks of things. You're sort of in the way. Don't take this the wrong way. But move.
Just in the...
Okay, I think that's the basic idea here. We've got our storeroom. It's a bit ugly in the storeroom, but hey, it's a storeroom, right? We're going to have a shopkeeper in there. Probably I'll put a door here as well, because why wouldn't you? And I'm going to have another shop on that side. Same thing, same kind of storeroom. And then I'm going to have a doorway into the residential area. Well, actually, it's going to be a doorway into the security room that leads to the residential area. I'm going to have some sort of separation like that. And hopefully that will be a little more pleasant for the vault dwellers. So if we do get traders, the traders can come here, trade with the shops, and then not wander around. Yeah, whatever. And not have to, you know, put up with traders randomly wandering into the residential area. So that's what I'm thinking. I still haven't decided what I'm going to do on the second floor. I'm also wondering whether or not I should have brought the entire thing one step closer. Because now that I look at it, it does look a little... It's all going to depend very much on how I have the upper floor. If I have the upper floor one back so that it's a tiered approach, I actually think the front of these shops should be closer. If, on the other hand, I'm going to have... You know what? That's going to look better. I think it's going to make it look more organic. And you know what that means? Yes, indeed. That means I'm moving the entire damned thing 1 foot. Oh, God. Oh, can I do that? I suppose so. But oh my God. Out of curiosity, can I just... do like this, and then sort of, you know, pick the entire thing up and move it across. Please tell me I can do that, because the idea of moving the entire thing... Okay. It's not going to snap into place, is it? Of course it's not going to snap into place. Why did I think it would snap into place? Come on, come on, come on. Right, now I think I am going to have to... Oh, well, that's the decision then. Do I want it closer? How is it going to look? Let's just bring some of the pieces over so that we get a vague idea before I move everything across. Because it's a little flaky, believe it or not, because... Well, I'm sure you do believe it. Because of the way the snapping works. So if I came here, and there was a door there to the shop, and a window straight into the shop, and the same thing on the other side. So we've got three spaces wide. That's going to be cozier, isn't it? You're going to feel like you're in a small... But, at the same time, it is also going to be what you would call pokey. Actually, I can leave that one there. It is going to be pokey. So maybe it was better where it was. It's not going to let me move this one back. Right, I'm going to leave it where it was. I am going to do a tiered approach. If it's a bit too large in the center, I may put something else in the center area as well. I mean, I'm thinking of having a gaming area. You know what? We're going to leave it this size. I'm just going to have to repair the damage I've just done. I think I've got the basics. We've got one shop here with a square, reasonably large storage. This is going to be for my standard general trader. I'm going to have a smaller shop here, slightly different angle, and it's got a smaller storage room. I'm probably going to have this as my tailor, I think. That probably is how I'm going to do this. I'm going to have some sort of door under here going to the engineering department. And the Overseer's office is going to be right up there overlooking this area, I think. The other option is to have the Overseer's office over this area, overlooking... See, I kind of don't want that. I want the Overseer's office to be, you know, I think central, looking over there. And I'm going to move this section...
Are you sure there isn't someone more suited to all this?
I gotta tell you...
Hey.
Sir?
I just want you to go and stand, just over there.
Over here.
My pleasure.
It's nothing personal, but you
wait there.
Keep trying to get in my way.
Right.
So, and this is going to be the residential area that you're going to come through. There's going to be a security room here, and then you'll pass through, and then the residences will start somewhere here. That is my current plan. I'm worried it's a little large. I'm going to have some, I don't know, some nice things in this area. I'm still a bit worried I've got it too far back. I feel like there's too much open space now on the left, but I have to tell you, the thought of moving all that has spent me, I have spent hours trying to mess around with this, getting all the doors to snap correctly. They don't snap brilliantly. And honestly, I think I'll end up going mad if I have to move it again. So, it probably won't look as open as I think it will once I've got everything up and running. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to build an upper floor above here. And I'm going to leave this kind of open. I'm going to make a kind of restaurant bar, but I'm going to have it open. So, I don't know how exactly I'm going to do this. I think what I have to do is... All of these have got to go. Obviously, we're not going to be doing anything with those. But it's going to be something along the lines of... No, not those. Maybe those? That's a column top. I'm looking to have a fairly extended... Yeah. Something like that is what I'm thinking. I mean, it's not completely ironed out idea, but having the upper floor where I'm thinking I'm going to have a clinic up there. We'll have some sort of stairway going up to that area. I'm not 100% sure where at the moment. We're going to have to see. But I'm going to need some pillars and things there as well. I'll have to sort that out. This is going to be a kitchen. Just going to have some cooking stuff and that so that they can make food. And then I'm going to have tables and this sort of thing. So we've got a kind of restaurant thing. And then I'll have perhaps some pool tables and a few other recreational things in this area. So it's kind of a place to come and hang out. Bit of a bar. That sort of thing. I still feel like there's a bit too much space on this side. However, I suspect once I get some, you know, if I get some decorations in, it'll suddenly feel a little less spacious. I mean, I could actually have something right here when you walk in, facing you. But I kind of don't want that. I want to have this a little more open. I was thinking of having a weapons and armor shop, but I was going to have those up above. At least that was my original thinking. Okay, so this is what I've got so far. It's beginning to shape up. I moved the bar back a little, and I added a few pieces of furniture. I'm not going to add a lot of furniture until I've done the basic structure, but I just wanted to get a feel for this, and I don't know, I think it works. I've added a stair to the upstairs area. I am going to have possibly a seated sort of an upstairs seated area for people to sit and relax, dine and drink. But I am going to have at least one other shop up here.
Whoa!
Okay, the settlers are enjoying the drink. And I'm going to have a clinic up here. That's what I'm going to have, a clinic with doctor services, that type of thing. And I'm having two different ways up there. These two shops, I've got them set up pretty much how I want them, I think. And I've got a security room. This is going to be the transition point from the atrium where, you know, outsiders may be allowed to come and trade, and the residential area. I'm going to have all of the major different areas, the residential area, the engineering area, separated by security checkpoints. This one's going to be fairly major. This is going to be the central hub for security. I'll have a couple of desks in here. I don't think I'm going to have turrets in here. It seems a little brutal to have turrets at this point, although I'd kind of like one, but maybe on a switch, so they can flick a switch and the turret will come on. But then, you know, when they don't flick a switch, it's off and it's not making a noise and threatening everybody. This is going to lead through into the residential area. I need to make a lot of different, I don't know what you'd call it, apartments. I've also added a second way up here so that the residents can go straight to the clinic and possibly to the overseer's office. The overseer's office I'm going to have up here. I haven't completely decided how I'm doing it, but I think I'm having the overseer's office one floor up over here, and underneath there will be passages going to the water place and engineering. So I'm going to have a couple of different... Whoa! Okay. Still got a door. Right. So that's what I'm thinking. I'm not completely happy about the security thing, though, because honestly, I sort of almost feel like I need another security checkpoint between here and the clinic, which is going to be here. So I'm going to make a very small security checkpoint. But, yeah. So this is to stop people invading the residency from the... Am I seeing some... Yeah, you do see some occasional flickers, don't you? I think this is because I've got the wrong things intersecting. I don't think this...
Thanks for your help, pal.
I was glad to help out.
Oh god, I took my glasses off. Timing. Who knows what would have happened to us?
Oh god, I almost... Right, we've got a few new settlers, and I accidentally almost gave one my sunglasses, and I'm hungry and... I am always hungry and thirsty. Was it those? Those, wasn't it? Yeah, right. So, I don't think you're supposed to have these window pieces in corners, to be honest. I think I'm going to avoid doing that. It was difficult. It was really difficult to get it set up.
All the soda you can.
And I am even thinking about removing it just to keep it consistent. However, when you do that, I think you lose some of the open feeling of the shop. But it took me so long to get them placed because they won't click into... Is that... No, that's how it's supposed to be, isn't it? That's for some reason, it just looked a little odd. That's how it's supposed to be. It was a bit difficult to get it clicking into place. So from now on, what I'm going to do is avoid... Same here, actually. I wanted a window in the kitchen to look out on this side. I thought it would be nice. I am going to put some seats here. I haven't decided exactly what sort, though. I might have this being a little more cozy, maybe some sofas, and upstairs we'll have some dining tables. Because I've decided I'm going to definitely have two stories open here, so we get a bit of a feeling of space. And I think if you're going to live in a vault, having a room where there is a feeling of space is important. I know this vault is not like one of the originals where the people are not ever going to leave. They can wander out at any point. But, you know, I think it's nice. Bit of space. The rest of it's going to feel fairly pokey. So, I think what I want to do is work on the upstairs a little now. Although... Honestly, I actually think what I should do is decide about the Overseer's office. I've got two choices. I can have the Overseer's office, the window for the Overseer, here. Right here, looking over the atrium. He'll have a good view of the... I say he. I guess it's me now. I guess I'm the Overseer. Am I the Overseer? I'm the Overseer, aren't I? I should make myself an apartment. I'm going to have the entire upper area just for me. Yes, this is going to... I'm the Overseer. I am in charge. That's probably a worrying thought. I'm never going to be here once I finish building it. But there you go. Or the other option is to have the window here, but one floor up. I.e. have an overhang. Like this. This overhang here. I've made... I might want to reduce the caffeine levels. I've made this overhang so people can walk over there to the clinic from that side. But maybe over here what I'll do is I'll make an overhang. People can't walk to it, but I'll have the Overseer's office overlapping. I'm not sure. Yeah, I think the first thing I need is a security checkpoint again. I mean, I've got the checkpoint into the residential area, but... I almost certainly need one here, because this is going to be the junction to the hydroponics bay, which is going to be over there, the water, and the engineering, as well as the way to the Overseer for most people, at least, you know, for people who are visiting from the outside. So I need a security room here, too. I'm worried I'm going to have slightly too many security... checkpoints, basically. This is a tiny bit worrying. Maybe I should have that as central security, and this should be... I might make this a little smaller. Although, it's difficult to make this smaller and have a window into the atrium, and I thought it was nice to have the security. Maybe I won't do that then. Maybe I will have... Ah, well, I can see. This is going to be the central security then. That actually makes a lot more sense as well, because then they can see into the atrium. So, okay, let's... Okay, this will work. And actually, I think this should be my main security hub. I'm actually thinking of making it larger, making it one... One, I don't know what you call it, one square deeper, and making this the central security hub, and then removing this one. Well, not removing it, but maybe converting this one into maybe another shop. I don't really need this entrance into here. Maybe what I can do is actually have an entrance just straight up top. I mean, there's no reason why I can't have another security room here. This will be the residential security, but this will control access to the atrium for the residents. And then we have another shop downstairs, and then the residential entrance could be right there. That would probably be kind of cool, actually. If you think about that, let's just... Right. Oh, yeah, because of the way I've done this, it's... let's just use atrium walls for now. I need to use the normal door pieces. Something like that. If I have that as the main...
So damn hungry. Maybe I'll get another drink.
Well, why would you be hungry? We've got an endless... I know you're not growing any food here yet, but we've got an endless supply of food. I mean, the only thing is... I know this is going to sound really daft, but I don't like the doorway in the center and that one there. I almost feel like they should be... Well, that door should be underneath as well, although that would make it a little awkward. What sort of shop would I have down here is the million-dollar question. Of course, I could move... the door to that side and see how that looks. Let's try that. I'll deal with the... The thing is I'm actually going to have my clinic door somewhere over there. Now, that looks fairly ridiculous, actually. Then, out of curiosity, can I move the one down below? I mean, I'm sure I can. Oh, but I spent such a long time getting these things positioned. And honestly, I think that just works. Oh, I don't know. I'm going to give that some more thought. The important thing is, I think this is going to be my main security. I will have a small security up there that controls that particular entrance to the main body. And that's all I really need. The visitors will be allowed in the atrium, but to get to the overseers or any other major area, they'll need to go through at least one of the security checkpoints. For the rest of the security checkpoints, what I'm going to do is have those at what will be exits. Now, for example, this one here is an exit to the water place. I may build another security building down at the bottom just as a precaution. Well, I'm going to build some barricades down there for sure. Okay, I've been kind of busy, and I've got a fair amount done, I think. It doesn't look much at the moment, but what I decided to do was move the security room back one square so that it's its own room and that there's a corridor between it and the atrium area. So, people can come in now and then head off to either the engineering department, the water plant, or... Well, originally I was going to make this hydroponics, but I've changed my mind. I think I'm going to leave this area blank for now and expand upon it at a later date. I'm thinking some more entertainment type stuff for my guys. And The hydroponics could be down here, so perhaps what I might do is have hydroponics over here, all the farming and that type of thing, and then we go all the way down there and have engineering down there. And by engineering, what I mean is a lot of crafting benches, that sort of thing. But also, I want to experiment with the conveyor belts and stuff like that, ammo making. I've not done any of that, actually, so that could be interesting. So, I've got a lot of room in that direction, so I actually think that you saving this space for something, I don't know, cinema, anything, you know, just something a bit more fun is a good idea. This is the security room again. So, I think I'm going to use these security rooms a little more like this, so they are off to the side of where everyone walks, so people don't have to walk through them. This does mean I've got to rethink this. What I might do is change this to a common room, have a seated area where people can just sit and chat. I might have a security desk here, just in case. But I don't think so, actually. I think what I'm going to do is have a security office here that people have to walk through to get to the residential area. Not through, past, to get to the residential area. That way we've got a second security office, but again, you don't walk through them, which I think will work better. And that way, people could walk up in here and do whatever's going to be done here. And even if they then come via this, I might move this as well, they're still going to go past security. So if they're not supposed to be there, they will get stopped. That is my thinking. I've got a few more settlers, actually. The place is becoming rather popular, and happiness is increasing. This is what I spent quite a lot of time on. I blocked it off. To give this sort of illusion of living in a vault, once we've... illusion. Of course we're living in a vault, but you know what I mean? Not living in a giant cavern. I mean, who knows? Maybe one day I will fill this cavern. Maybe I will actually have all sorts of things going all the way to the roof, but you know what I mean? It's... with a vault, I always want a feeling that on the other side of the wall is just rock. That's the idea. That's what makes it so damned safe, isn't it? So anyway, this should help with that illusion. It's not the neatest concrete work I've ever done, and there does seem to be a gap there, but I've actually caused it to go into the wall further up, so there isn't an actual gap. Best I could do. I did not assign her to this post, but she seems to have taken it up. I put some defenses here, and then I built this. I built a wall here. You can see I got a little carried away. I was just busy trying stuff out in silence, and realised I'd gotten a bit ahead of myself. I went into zombie mode. You know how it is, just testing things. I think this is kind of cool. I'm going to put a door here. I may even put one of those doors that shuts when the power goes off. I've used one of those right here. As you can see, it requires power to open. And I put a floor in here. I don't know whether I'm going to build anything down there. I doubt it. But I now have an area I can set up and make secure right here. I don't think I'm going to put people here. I've got a turret here for now. I think what I'm going to do is leave that blocked off. I'm probably going to set up a security room right here. This is where I want a security room, and you walk through it, probably. This is, you've got to go through the security room to get to the outside world, or to go to the water treatment plant. This is really what I would consider one of the high security points. So that's what I've done so far. As you can see, I've been getting a little off track, because the original goal here was to actually set up an overseer's office so I could try out the overseer's terminal. And I'm not exactly close to doing that. Can we set up pressure pads that will open and close as we go over? Because that would be kind of like laser tripwires, which just opens and closes. That would be really nice. I have seen the occasional flicker, by the way. I have a feeling I've used some of these pieces in ways they were not designed to be used. But this seems to be the door piece that's flickering. The door inside. Difficult to know. It doesn't happen with all of them. It could be because these are mismatching pieces. This is common area pieces and this is utility pieces. That is actually annoying me. Which piece is it? Is it the door? No, it's not the door. Okay, it's actually... Thing is, if I take the end cap away now, it could take me a year and a day to get it back. Yes, it could. Occasionally when I moved something, it totally refuses to go back, and I had to remove all the pieces around it. And seeing as some of them took quite a while to place, it got kind of annoying. I've actually spent several hours getting to this point. A lot of it was experimentation. I'll think about that. I may think about trying to fix that somehow. God knows how that's going to be. I found a few others and I did fix them. There were a few others and I've neatened up some of the wall pieces and columns and generally got things looking a little neater. But if you remember, the original task was to set up a bloody overseer's office. And I think I'm going to do that here. Oh god. The question is, how exactly to do that? Oh, and I'm the type of guy who will never settle down where pretty girls are.